He is a final year IT engineering student from SSM College of Engineering. And when I asked him about the theme, about what one decision influenced his life, he said one day he was sitting in his canteen and thinking about how to bump the next lab session. And then he came across Joss, who told him, "Dude, I have an excellent place for you to bunk class and start Toastmasters. Do you have $100? Wanna come with me?" I said, and then he came along. And he says that is the one best decision in the last few years of his life. Toastmasters has given him the confidence to take up more roles in his college and department. And he has also executed them with the same confidence. He said, and I quote, "If he hadn't decided to bunk his class that day, if I hadn't decided to bunk his class that day, I wouldn't even know Toastmasters, what Toastmasters is today. I'm glad that you made that decision." So before I call upon Ashwin, let me call his evaluator, Toastmaster Vijay Rajan, to read out the project objectives.
Thank you, DMD. Toastmaster Ashwin has set up a project for CC4 from the Competent Communicator panel. The objectives are: select the right words and sentence structure to communicate your ideas clearly, accurately, and vividly. Use rhetorical devices to enhance and emphasize ideas. Eliminate jargon and unnecessary words. Use correct grammar. Timer, please note the timing is 5 to 7 minutes. All the best.
Toastmaster Ashwin, a journey to paradise. A journey to paradise, Toastmaster Ashwin.
Back in my native, I had a friend. He had wanderlust. He lived as if his life's mission was to travel to all the tourist places that ever existed. He even annoyed me and my friends with his pictures he took there and the gadgets and goodies he buys there. One fine day, I went up to him and asked, "Dude, how can you even live like this without any proper routine?" And he said, the famous quotes, whenever you Google something about travel, you can find this. He said, "The whole world is a book, and the man who hasn't traveled has only read a page." Good afternoon, fellow Toastmasters, and welcome guests. So, this one quote had opened my eyes. I decided to do the same thing. I wanted to travel to a hill station. This was a trip to Coorg and Karnataka in my second year of college. It was a memorable one because I was one of the four coordinators who organized the trip for a crowd of 120 people. We started off from Chennai Central and went to Mysore, and then we took a bus to Coorg. Since it was my first trip to a hill station, I was happy as a kid. Even though the journey was tiring, I was actually excited because since it was my first trip to a hill station, the whole tiring journey was worth the effort because the place which we had arrived had amazed us all. The soothing sun and the warm climate and the cool breeze was a feast to the eyes and to the body. Our first spot in the hit list was Raja's Seat. Raja's Seat is a place with layers of greenery and it is situated in the town of Madikeri. Raja's Seat was situated between two chains of hills, making it a perfect spot to watch the sunset. We had one of our best times of our life there. I was really happy because until then the trip was going really good, because if there was any problem, I'll be questioned. Then people started becoming tired. They were dying to take a bath. So I decided to take them to one of the nature's largest natural showers called the Abbey Falls. Abbey Falls. It was originated north to the north of Coorg, between the coffee plantations. Abbey Falls is a place having a hanging bridge from where you can see the whole falls without even turning your head. And when we reached there, we the cloud started sprinkling frozen snowflakes. It was so cool, but we enjoyed a lot. At that moment, I realized it was indeed a trip to paradise. We had so much fun that we even forgot that Mr. Moon had come up to visit us. We rushed to a nearby resort. We spent the night there. But we spent the night there restlessly because the next day of the trip had the actual fun. Because the next day had rafting. Members of six were formed and occupied the boats in the blink of an eye. We were all excited for the whole rafting experience. We breezed along the river. Literally, I have no words to explain the joy, amount of joy I experienced that day. I was brimming with joy. But then later came the time for us to take care of our tummies too. I and my other fellow coordinators had arranged a complimentary dinner for all the 120 people. At that time, we went there and had our tummies filled up. The ravishing rotis and the marvelous masalas. I still feel hungry whenever I think about that. I still feel hungry now. And then we went to a nearby another resort to spend the night. The nap we took there was the shortest of all my life because the next day had another exciting plan. It was a place where anyone who visits Karnataka would fail to visit it. Any guesses? No, it's Wonderla. And as the name goes, it was indeed a wonderful place. I decided and vowed to my friends that I would not miss any ride. So I tried them all and yes, even vomited after some. I vomited so much, two of my friends had to carry me to the bus. But then came the time for us to bid goodbye to Coorg and Bangalore. 3 days of our life went evaporated like 3 minutes. Coorg had so much to offer, but we didn't have the resources and time to explore the nook and corner of it. Coorg was one of the best places I've ever visited, and even now when I go to Coorg, I still feel the same. So fellow Toastmasters and honorable guests, if you feel like escaping the bustling city life or you want to have a stellar time, I would suggest you to visit Coorg. You'll love it. Thank you.